Dallas coach Vicky Johnson was fired via Zoom. Ouch. Let's take a deep dive into how, why, and if coaching is a real problem in Dallas. The following statement was issued by the Wings on Monday, 19 September, 2022, advising that Johnson would not be returning. While our organization has taken steps forward this season, at this time, I believe a change provides our team with the best opportunity to achieve our long-term goals of advancing in the playoffs and ultimately competing for a WNBA championship, Wings President and CEO Greg Bibb stated. I would like to thank Vicky for her work on behalf of the organization and wish her the best in her future endeavors. Johnson was informed of the decision around 9:30 a.m. on Monday on a Zoom call. She was shocked by the news, saying, "I thought I was leading the right way," Johnson said Monday. Johnson went on to say, "I wasn't perfect. My players are not perfect, but I felt like we were going to grow together and build something special in Dallas." Johnson had a 32-36 record in two seasons. She led Dallas to the playoffs both years, leading the franchise to its first playoff win since 2009 season when the team was in Detroit. While the records seem unspectacular, it should be noted that Johnson had the highest winning percentage, 471, of any Wings coach since the franchise left Detroit. Her first season with Dallas was a pleasant surprise as the team finished as the number 7 seed and made the 2021 playoffs. This past season, more was expected and it seemed there was always turmoil throughout the season. Dallas slumped in the middle of the season, winning only 7 of 21 games from 26 May to the 28th of July. There was also player drama as well, as Isabella Harrison went to Twitter to complain about playing time and then went on TikTok questioning Johnson's play calls. This is not the first time Johnson had issues with players. Johnson and forward Alicia Gray had tension in year one. Johnson badmouthed Gray in the press after losing to Las Vegas, saying her time with Team USA in the 3-on-3 competition delayed her getting familiar with their offense system. Ironically, when Greg Bibb hired Johnson, he cited her experience as a player would allow her to relate to players better, saying, "Vicky was the right person to lead our team at this time. Someone who can relate to players, who understands the challenges of the profession, and someone who knows how to develop the skill sets of young professional athletes." There's no doubt that Johnson was old school and was not real warm and fuzzy with players. Star guard Arike Ogunbowale had her struggles during the 2022 season. First, at the end of the Wings Sparks game, Ogunbowale had a chance to tie the game with two free throws. She missed the first, and then on the second, she did a bizarre double pump free throw, which was a violation. Ogunbowale was obviously frustrated and walked over to the bench where she kicked the scorer's table. Watch as Johnson gives her the "what the hell are you doing" look with hands on hips, but she doesn't say anything. This was then followed up by the ball kicking incident against the Storm, where after a shot that was heaved just after the halftime buzzer, the ball bounced off the backboard towards Ogunbowale, who kicked at it before walking off the court. The ball flew behind the head of Storm forward Brianna Stewart and into the crowd. She was ejected for kicking the ball. After the game, Ogunbowale tweeted, "I was in no way trying to kick the ball. The half was over. I tried to control the ball with my feet like I always do if the ball comes at my feet. To be ejected for something like this is wild. From here on out, I'll try to remember WNBA refs aren't fans of soccer players. Hashtag go Wings." Now, normally coaches fall all over themselves to support their stars. However, Johnson was less than impressed, saying, "We're not on the soccer field. We're on the basketball court, and you have to respect the game, period. We play basketball with our hands." So Johnson really doesn't have Ogunbowale's back on this. There's a clear defense because days earlier, the Wings played the Aces and an incident happened during that game. And I would have pointed that out. I made a video on it. Check it up here at the end of this video if you want to check it out. Because I think there was a clear case to be made how Ogunbowale was overpunished for this indiscretion. Anyway, the management of Ogunbowale will likely be the focus of the Wings' search for their future coach, as I suspect they want a coach that will do a better job of developing her, as currently her game is very ball dominant, and other players often struggle to play with her as they're standing around while she's going one-on-one. The good and bad of her game was demonstrated when she suffered her core muscle injury, which resulted in her being forced to miss the end of the regular season. Marina Mabry's numbers markedly improved with Ogunmowale's absence, which also resulted in wins and allowing the Wings to secure the number 6 seed. Check out these numbers. In 28 games Mabry played with Ogunmowale, Mabry averaged 12 points, 3.5 rebounds, and 3.5 assists per game, while shooting 40% from the field and 32% from the three-point range. In 6 games that Mabry played without Ogunmowale, she averaged 21 points, 4.3 rebounds, and 4.7 assists per game, while shooting 49% from the field and 44% from three-point range. So overall, I think the change that Greg Bibb speaks of is basically how Ogunmowale is going to be managed in the future. However, we don't know for sure, as Bibb was unwilling to front the media, as he will not speak to the media or take questions until a new coach is hired. Bibb's reluctance to speak with the media is understandable, as if anyone's performance is open to question, it would certainly be his. Let's take a look at the Greg Bibb era in Dallas. Bill Cameron is currently the majority owner of the Dallas Wings. He led an investment group to purchase the WNBA franchise in 2009 and then moved the team from Detroit to Tulsa. By 2015, Cameron felt the location of Tulsa wasn't working out as well as he'd hoped. He decided that Dallas-Fort Worth was more attractive from a business point of view, and the team moved and was rebranded as the Wings. When the franchise moved to Dallas, Greg Bibb joined as minority owner and president. Bibb had worked in sports prior to joining the Wings, as he had been in public relations for the major indoor soccer league in the late 90s and early 2000s. He also spent 5 years as the chief operating officer of the Washington Mystics. He was vice president at the Washington Wizards for 3 years as well. He officially joined the management team of the Dallas Wings in 2015. 2022 was the first year that the Dallas Wings have not had a losing record under his tenure, as they went 500 with an 18-18 record. Bibb has had publicized feuds with players, which has led to their departures, such as Skylar Diggins-Smith and center Liz Cambage. In 2018, Bibb dealt swing forward Ariel Power to the Mystics and got nothing out of the trade. Powers won the title in 2019 and made a point of calling out Bibb once she did with this tweet. "Thank you, Dallas. Thank you for trading me, Greg, because I have a championship and I don't think I would have gotten that with you." After the departures of Diggins-Smith and Cambage, the plan was for the Wings to build through the draft. The draft record under Bibb is uneven. Ariki Ogunmowale was his best pick during his tenure. Satu Sabally and Alicia Gray are also solid picks. However, 5 former first-round selections are no longer on the roster. The jury is still out on the 2021 draft class as well, as 2 players are gone, while Charlie Collier and Awak Kawir, the first and second overall picks of the 2021 draft, have underperformed to date. All told, the Wings have picked 13 players inside the top 10 during the 7 drafts headed by Bibb. So far, it's yielded 1 cornerstone player in Ogunmowale and possibly a second in Alicia Gray. Now, Bibb blames coaching for the lack of player development and the lack of wins, and he's taken it out on them. In 2018, Coach Fred Williams was let go late in the season after he and Bibb got in an altercation after a game. Former WNBA player Taj McWilliams-Franklin finished the 2018 season as the interim coach. Then Brian Agler, who had won WNBA championships in Seattle and Los Angeles, was hired by Dallas, but he was gone after 2 losing seasons, during which the Wings went 18-38 and didn't make the playoffs. Agler said at the time that he agreed to part ways with the Wings because he and team management had different philosophies on how to get where we all wanted to go. Then Bibb hired Johnson, who was his most successful hire to date. She achieved a 500 record this year and led Dallas to their first playoff game win. Not series win, but game win in a playoff game, as that had not previously been achieved in the Bibb era. Greg Bibb's overall record since 2016 has been 92 wins and 134 losses. Given his track record, how much trust should Greg Bibb be given in making the next coaching hire? Will Bibb's record come into play in the coaching search? Should majority owner Bill Cameron look to hire a coach and give them the GM role as well, like what Chicago and Minnesota have done with James Wade and Cheryl Reeves, respectively? Now, be warned, the coach GM role does come with pitfalls. If you don't believe me, then watch my next video on Derek Fisher's management of the Los Angeles Sparks. So what do you think? Should Johnson have been fired? Should the Wings bring in a coach GM? Or should Bibb get another chance to get it right? Leave your comments below. Thanks for watching.